till day, that is 2 weeks, there is no change in the size of the epithelial defect. By day 20, that is 4 weeks, it has just marginally reduced. So this is giving you an idea, maybe there is ischemia which you have missed or not recognized, or the current management is not adequate. You need to be more aggressive and try some other therapy rather than a conservative management. So this again, this is showing you the different stages, how it is healing, and this is the corresponding OCTA photographs of the same. So basically the conclusion here is that clinical examination alone is an insufficient method to assess the presence and the degree of ischemia. So OCTA gives you a rapid and a non-contact process, it is non-invasive, and since chemical injuries are a dynamic process, the grade 1 which you may feel on the first day may become grade 3 or grade 4 as the time progresses, as shown in the previous photograph. So serial monitoring and fluorescein staining is extremely important to differentiate vasos ischemia from vasospasm, which we call as the mental blanching. So it is definitely useful, but it is still not at the level which we would expect because the machines are not easy to come by, they are expensive. And again, there is a lot of variation in the quality of the images, how to grade them from the OCT, still we don't have a classification system. That is why we say that prevention is always better than cure. We have this awareness campaign from Shankar Mehta Chennai, in which they have partnered with the government as well, and they want this advisory to come on the tuna packets, that don't send children to buy tuna packets because they're potentially blinding it. So it's a true ocular emergency, it causes significant ocular morbidity. We need protective care as well for patients who are in hazardous occupations. We need a better classification system which takes into account the role of scleral or limbal ischemia. And Opta is still not there at the level which we want to expect.
Chalo, 5 adhi to aa gaya.